think this is sexy? Let me ruin it for you. Hey guys, you think this is sexy? Well, let me ruin it for you. Girls poop. Really, they do. Including me. At least twice a week. If they don't do it twice a week, then they're constipated. So girls and boys, if you're not pooping at least twice a week, go to your doctor because you're constipated. Anyway, my name's Katie. I love Halloween a lot, but I'm in Germany and they don't celebrate Halloween here. So I decided to celebrate by doing a bunch of costumes. They're last minute costumes because obviously tomorrow is Halloween. And I know a lot of people are just busy with their lives. So I'm here to give you some ideas. I hope to deal with a lot of personality types. The first genre I'm going to go through is Harry Potter. As you can see, I love Harry Potter. See? Heart, Harry Potter, Harry Potter's face, and the quote, "We're fighting," in reference to the last movie and the last battle at Hogwarts. Let's move on to pop culture. This is my Hannah Montana outfit. Why is this my Hannah Montana outfit, you might be asking? Because if you go to Walmart and you look at things that Miley Cyrus has designed, it's this. And this is something, it's very poppy, it's very pink, it's very fairy-like. And I have my dangling earrings. Hannah Montana is a really easy thing to do because anything you have sequined or bejeweled or glittery or anything, Hannah Montana works. Now, the key to Hannah Montana is don't wear too much makeup. You can do a light, glittery eyeshadow and lip gloss. But even though she's known for being kind of skanky, the Hannah Montana on the show really isn't. So wear something like this. The next pop icon we're going to do is, if you can't tell already, and man, I'm kind of chubby, is Lady Gaga. Now, the thing with Lady Gaga is she can be slutty. This is my slutty version of her. I am not the skinniest person, so I chose to do a more modest kind of slutty thing with her. I'm wearing a bathing suit top. Another way to do it is to wear a very covering bra. And as example, this is my zebra bra. It covers a lot, and it would be a cute thing. I'm wearing a skirt and high heels, toothbrush in my hair, just crazy hair. If you want to do even more conservative than this, which I guess is kind of hard to do if you want to do Lady Gaga, here's what you do. All you do is you ask someone you know who's a guy for their business jacket. Put it on, and there you go, Lady Gaga. If you want to individualize this, it's really easy. Do things with your hair or buy a cheap pair of sunglasses and glue toothbrushes, cigarettes, Pepsi cans, use inspiration from her videos. And there you go, Lady Gaga. Or if you want, you could even be Madonna, because it really depends on what age demographic you are and who you see that I look like. Now, if you're like me, you want to dress cute and maybe even slightly sexy without looking like a slut. Unfortunately, Halloween costumes of today don't really give you the option. So today I'm going to do cute and sexy but not slutty costumes. The first one is the cat or dog, and it's rather easy. First, choose what color cat or dog you're going to be. I'm choosing black. I have a black wife beater and a black skirt. If I wanted to make this a little bit sexier, I would go with a corset. However, most people don't own one of these, so I'm not. First, what you do is you paint your nose with eyeliner, makeup, whatever, and do very whiskers. This is the cat. The dog, I'm not going to show you, so you got to learn that on your own. Next, take two of these, split your hair, put them up. Now, I really like the cat or dog or whatever because you see it a lot and it's always cute. Now, this isn't going to be very good because I'm trying to talk and do this at the same time. Next, more of a dog, but we'll ignore it. Next, you can fill up your sock more than this. You curvy. But all you do is you fill it up, you take a safety pin, which I don't have, and just put it right there. There you go. You got cute. You know, you can wear a push-up bra if you want to, whatever, and it's even more sexy, but it's a cat or a dog, and you got a tail. It's cute. You know, go with it. Now, this is your basic sexy librarian look. You know, a little chest, you can wear a push-up bra and kind of short skirt and heels. If you want to bump it up a little, or put on mascara. And, yeah, I hold my mouth open. Grab your favorite lipstick. I'm choosing red to enhance the sexiness, why this is sexy, is because women are known to having more of a difference between their skin tone and lip tone than guys, and that's where the whole lipstick thing came from. And next, to make it a little sexy, but you know, in a librarian way, I'm putting my hair up using one of these. Now, I don't know if this is particularly librarian-like, but I always think of that. There you go, you got your... And you know, I'm not a good model for this, because I'm not exactly the most sultry, sexy person. But, you know, I'm sexier looking than I was before. Maybe I look like an idiot. Thumbs up if I don't. Thumbs down if I do look like an idiot. Oh, a super easy and super cute one is a MySpace or Facebook photo. Basically, put on your favorite picture-taking outfit, do your makeup, get pretty like you're gonna take photos of yourself, and then make a sign and wear it with one of those quotes that you see, like, oh, you can do this with a friend, with things like saying best friends are the best policy, or just things like sunshine. Mine says life is like a box of chocolates. And basically, whenever you go trick-or-treating or see your friends, just smile, duck face, and do MySpace poses. It's a cute, fun way to dress normally and do a last-minute, maybe 5-cent piece of paper thing. Now on to the just funny and not trying to be sexy or cute. This is good for people who just want to have fun and aren't looking for a boyfriend, because the one after this one really probably won't get you one. The first one is to be an old lady. This one's really easy. I didn't have anything to wear, but wear a bathrobe, wear a nightie. That's why I'm wearing this, is because it kind of looks like one. Get a cane. I have a Quidditch umbrella. Walk around like this. And usually I would put my hair up in curlers. I don't have any. Find ask your grandma for jewelry. I have these from my grandma. And another good thing is with lipstick and makeup, don't wear too much makeup. And I'm going to put on my grandmother's lipstick that she gave me. It's a kind of pink color. Let's see how it works. I mean, it's a bit kiddish, which is why she probably gave it to me, but... It's something that you kind of have to work with. If you want to, you can add on wrinkles with eyeliner pencils or something. You kind of have to work with this. These are just ideas. I can't give you the costume completely, people. My final costume is the male. There's a variation on this that I'll show you with just a quick change of the shirt to a pirate. Male pirate, obviously. Now, to do this, just wear jeans, a wife beater, something not too girly. And you should put your boxers out. I pulled mine up, and luckily I have enough of a muffin top that I don't need extra butt to do it. Now, it's really easy to become a guy. First, you put your hair up. Simple. Now, I've done this before in public, so if you're feeling kind of scared about it, people will laugh, but it's funny. I mean, oh, yeah, you have to also have to take off your lipstick. I have a mirror, so you know. But you have, it's a good way because you forget what you look like a lot, and it's funny to see people who haven't seen you before look at you and just be surprised. Now, with becoming a man, it's mostly about the makeup. Now, you can do it really with two things. I usually also use eyeliner, but really what you need is concealer and mascara. Why you need concealer is, as I said before, the main reason for lipstick is because it makes your lips a different color from your face. So I use the concealer on my lips to make it more like my face, therefore making it more manly. Now, as an 18-year-old, even though I'm a legal adult, I'm still a teenager, so I still have pimples, which is why I use this stuff. Now, it's good to use an old mascara for this because you're not wasting anything that you love. So if you have any old ones, it's really good for this. Okay, first, you do your eyebrows. It's okay if you mess up, because you can just clean it up, and guys have bushy eyebrows anyway. Next, you do your mustache area. Now, girls, admit it, we all have hair there. So that's actually rather easy. If you want to, you can do facial hair like this. Now, this isn't very good because I'm doing it in a hurry, but I'll show you a picture later. get a little soul patch going. Now, if you're going to be a guy, you really can't forget these sideburns. These can go as far as you want to. I like the chop looking ones, so that's what I'm going to do. And I've done it all the way around. It's really, you get to choose your own facial hair. This is basically it. And you just go around and act like a dude and be like, yo, what's up? And grab your crotch a lot, because we all know guys scratch their balls. It's kind of gross. Please stop it, guys. Going from regular ball stretching guy to pirate is rather easy. All you need is a peasant shirt. You might remember these from when you were little. This is one, and they're really easy. This is actually inside out, but I'm in a hurry, so who cares? Put it on. Kind of womanly. So if you have fabric pants, Guccios, what are those called? Bohos? Those wavy pants or whatever, those are also good. And maybe manly shoes. If you want to add on, just cut up a coat hanger and get a hook. So guys, that's it. I hope that from the beginning to now, you are completely, like, not attracted to me, because I've de-womanized myself in every way. So actually, you know what? I want to feel sexy again. Well, I hope you all enjoyed it. Now guys, remember to have a safe, sexy, funny Halloween. And enjoy the fun, enjoy the candy, and eat as much as you want. I mean, I've gained weight here. And, you know, I'm not meant for corsets. I even had to loosen up in the back. And I'm okay with it. So eat that extra candy bar. And then if you actually are that freaked out by your weight, go run a mile or two. The endorphins will make you feel better with both the chocolate and the exercising. Be safe. Watch your drinks. Don't take cocaine from strangers or anyone. Don't do cocaine. And have a very, very, very wonderful, beautiful, Halloween-y Halloween. Bum, 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 bum.